Dear students, today I am going to solve some maths from the chapter algebra for your maths olympiad. So today's first problem is the equation for the statement one third of a number added to second multiple of 6 is 24 is. The options are y by 3 is equals to 12 plus 24. Option B, y by 3 plus 2 is equals to 24. Option C, y by 3 plus 12 is equals to 24. And option D, y by 3 is equals to 18 plus 24. Now we have to find the correct option. So the problem is, the equation for the statement, one third of a number added to second multiple of 6. So second multiple of 6 means 12. Because 6 into 2, first multiple is 6, second multiple is 12. So, if we take the number is y, one third of a number. So, if we take the number is y, then one third is y into 1 by 3. One third means multiply by 1 by 3. So, that means y by 3. Y by 3 is the one third of the number. And added to second multiple of 6, second multiple of 6 means 12 is equals to 24. So this is the correct answer, that y by 3 plus 12 is equals to 24. So option C is the correct. Next problem is, when Raju multiples a certain number by 17 and adds 4 to the product, he gets 225. Find the number. So the options are 13, 14, 15, 16. So the problem is, when Raju multiplies a certain number by 17. So if we take that the number is x and Raju multiplies a certain number by 17, that means multiple by 17, so x into 17, and adds 4 to the product. So when we multiply 17 with x, the product is 17x. So we have to add 4 with this product and he gets 225. Now we have to find the value of x. So 17x is equals to 225 minus 4. So when we transfer 4 to the right hand side, it will be minus 4. The sign will change. Now x is equals to, if we subtract 4 from 225, is 221 by 17. Now, if we divide 221 by 17, it will be 13. So, x is equals to 13. Okay, students? So, the correct option is A. Next problem. Equation for the statement. Equation for the statement twice the product, twice the product of M and N is equal to thrice their difference. Is the options are 3mn is equals to 2 into m minus n, mn is equals to 2 into m minus n, 2mn is equals to m minus n, and 2mn is equals to 3 into m minus n. So the problem is equation for the statement. So what is the statement? Twice the product of m and n. So product of m and n is, product of m and n is m into n, that means mn, and twice the product of mn is 2mn. Twice means multiply by 2. So twice the product of m and n is 2mn, is equal to the thrice of their difference. So their difference is m minus n, their difference is m minus n, and thrice means multiply by 3. So the equation is 2mn is equals to 3 into m minus n. So option D is the correct answer. Now next one. So I hope all of you understood. Next problem is, if 6 times of a number is 318, then the number is, the options are 53, 91, 0, and 72. These are the four options. So if 6 times a number, so if the number is x, suppose the number is x, and 6 times the number means 6x, and what is the result? The result is 318. So 6 times of a number is 318. Now calculate it. So x is equals to 318 by 6. Now if we divide 318 by 6, it will be 53. So therefore x is equals to 53. So that means A is the correct option. Understood? Next problem is, an algebraic expression 11 minus y can be written in statement form as, the options are 11 less than y, y less than 11, y more than 11, and option D is y divided by 11. So the problem is an algebraic expressions 11 minus y can be written as. So here y subtract 11, that means y less than 11. Obviously 11 is greater and y is smaller, so y less than 11. So B is the correct answer, students. Next problem. Problem number 6. Which of the following equations justify the given statement? The statement is, when x is divided by y, the quotient is added to the product of x and y. The options are x plus y by x, y by x plus yx, yx plus 2x by y, and x by y plus xy. So read the statement carefully, that when x is divided by y, so x is divided by y, that means x by y, x is divided by y means x by y, the quotient is, so x by y is the quotient now, the quotient is added to the product of xy, so added, that means plus, and product of xy, that means x into y. So here D is the correct option. Next problem. If 12 less than 3 times of a number is 27, then the number is, the options are 29, 39, 65 and 13. If 12 less than 3 times of a number, so if the number is x, if suppose the number is x, then 3 times of the number, that means 3x, 3 times of the number, that means 3x, and 12 less than 3 times the number, so 12 less than, that means minus 12, is equals to, the number is 27. Now calculate it. So 3x is equals to 27 plus 12. Now, because when we transfer minus 12 to the right hand side, it will be plus 12. So 3x is equals to 27 plus 12 is 39. So this implies x is equals to 39 by 3. Now if you divide 39 by 3, it will be 13. So x is equals to 13. So therefore the required number is 13. I hope all of you understood. Next problem. Problem number 8. The problem is, if x is equals to 3 and y is equals to 7, then find the value of x by 2 plus 4y plus 2. The options are 63 by 2, 65 by 2, 17 by 2, and D is 96. So here x is equals to 3 and y is equals to 7, so that means we have to put here, in the place of x we have to put 3 and in the place of y we have to put 7. So x by 2, that means 3 by 2, and 4y, that means 4 into 7 plus 2. Now calculate it. So it will be 3 by 2 plus 28 plus 2, so 3 by 2 plus 30. Now find the LCM. So it will be 3 plus 90. So that means here I made a mistake. It will be 60. So it is 63 by 2. So 63 by 2 is the correct option. Next. Problem number 9. To get the value of x, the number to be multiplied on either side of equation x by 5 is equals to 15 by 3 is, the options are minus 3, 15, 5 and 0. So to get the value of x, the number to be multiplied on either side of the equation x by 5 is equals to 15 by 3. So here the equation is x by 5 is equals to 15 by 3. So if you want to find the value of x, that means in the left hand side we have to keep only x. So that means we have to remove 5. Here the denominator is 5. So we have to remove this 5. So to remove this denominator, we have to multiply both sides by 5. So here x by 5 multiply by 5. So if we multiply 5 to the left hand side, we have to also multiply by 5 to the right hand side. So 5, 5 will be cut. So in the left hand side only x will left, and here we have to multiply 15 with 5. So 15 multiplied by 5 is 75 by 3. But students, here 75 by 3 is not the answer. Remember students, 75 by 3 is not the answer. The question is To get the value of x, the number to be multiplied on either side. The number to be multiplied on either side. So which number is multiplied by either side? 5 multiplied to the to either side. Okay. So here answer will be 5. So I hope all of you understood. So you have to practice such kind of maths for your upcoming Maths Olympiad. Thank you, students.